Are we ready to go? You're ready to film. Where did you go? Who's the camera facing? Facing me or you? Okay, fine. Okay. Now it's facing the right way. Okay, fabulous. Okay. Hello, everybody. My name is Carol Pushcat. I'm from the great state of Louisiana. And today I'm going to make some guacamole. Okay, this is Carol's famous guacamole. I've been making it for years. Okay, and now as you can see, I've already got two avocados chunked and in this bowl, okay? So we're going to throw in some ingredients. We're going to throw in some ingredients that you guys are going to be privileged to know exactly how I make my guacamole. Now, I use the same knife to cut everything. I find that using the same knife emulsifies the flavors. So you got to ask yourself, you know, how do you clean it? In between, I just give it a quick rub. You know what I mean? Just get the avocado off of there. Now, I always say something that my mama used to say to me when I was growing up, okay? She said, you can never have too much tomato. And I believe that to be true to this day. So whenever I'm using it in a recipe, I try to use as much as I can. Now, I'm the kind of person that I like my tomato meatier, okay? I like it to be a ripe. I like it to look like it's got something to live for. You know what I'm saying? Like it's got something, it's got purpose. And you're going to cut it into little chunks, okay? Little chunks like so. I'm just going to give you the real rough cut of this guacamole so you can see the effort that goes into it and decide if this is a recipe you want to pursue on your own. Now, here's a little fun fact for you. When I was little, you see these tomato seeds? Let me try to pick one up for you. You see tomato seeds? When I was little, I called these Triton's titties. You know the animated Little Mermaid and Triton? He's got them. that's not a lie. I used to call them Triton's titties because they got little Triton nips. Delicious. Okay, now we're going to mash up this avocado over here. Again, this is a fork that I purchased at IKEA. The Swedish make a good fork. You know, that's something that came out of World War II. They thought, what better way to fight the Nazis than with their utensils? You know what I mean? Because everyone uses utensils. And if you got a Nazi going, my God, this fork is amazing. This is superior to American forks, to German forks. Who made this fork? Oh, the Swedish? Oh, damn, we ain't gonna mess with them. Now you got purple onion. Some people call this red onion. I call those people idiots, okay? Because it's obviously purple. Now with onion, you don't need a whole lot, okay? A little onion goes a long way. That's something my mama also used to say to me. You know, remember in your dealings with people in the public, remember a little onion go a long way. You can interpret that how you will. I interpret it to mean that a little bit of sour, a little bit of statements that'll make you cry, you know, it's good in small doses. Werner, what are you doing? Why are you sneaking cookies while we're doing a broadcast? I swear to God, Bernard, I swear to God. Bernard is my cameraman. If you all haven't seen my Carol's Corner videos on Facebook Live, I work with a very talented troupe of individuals out of Melbourne, Florida, called Funky Dog Improv. If you haven't seen me, every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, I broadcast on Facebook Live on their Facebook channel, Funky Dog Improv, okay? Like a dog that is funky, Funky Dog Improv. And if you've seen me broadcast on there, you probably met Bernard. Bernard is my housemate. He is not my husband. We do not have a romantic relationship, okay? He is my housemate. He is my friend. And he's a special individual. Okay, now I add the onion. I added the purple onion, okay? You see here? Now I'm going to mix it in there. Oh, God. I got the core. It got me. Okay, so we got avocado. We got purple onion. We got tomato. And I took a little break. I've reprieved you all from my voice and put in some cumin, some black pepper, red pepper flakes, salt, and ginger. Always minced, because you want it thick enough to taste and coarse, okay? Always minced. Yes, Bernard, you're making that face at me. What? Garlic. Now, I will say with garlic, everybody, that Stephanie Meyer is writing a new Twilight book, okay? So you gotta load up on garlic. Because you're gonna have little teenagers obsessed with vampires again, okay? You got to be ready to go. And you know what my secret ingredient is? And I don't tell everybody, so you all lucky with this. My secret ingredient is fresh lime juice, and it has to be fresh. And I find, actually, that it actually tastes better when you get it on sale at Publix, the actual limes. There's something about paying less for a lime than you would at any other store that makes it taste better. Look at that. I'm gonna taste test it, see what else it needs. That's almost perfect how it is. That's how you know you're a good guacamole chef. When you can put in all the ingredients and then tell yourself, I was throwing a little over my shoulder for good luck. And then tell yourself what else it needs to make it superb, okay? I'm gonna do a little more red pepper, do a little more salt, put a little more fresh lime, and I'm gonna add a little more tomato. I like mine tomato heavy. Some people like theirs onion heavy. But I find you gotta strike a good balance. You see that nice cutting action? That's Gordon Ramsay approved. I actually took a class with him back in the 80s at one of his restaurants in Las Vegas. Get all them titties in there, okay? And he said, my knife skills are superior. So you're learning from a professional right now. I think too, the more arm flab you have as you're mixing, the more that this part of your body moves, the better it is, okay? Because it gives you momentum behind the swirling. Done. Perfect. So you seen it right here. Carol Butchergast, famous guacamole. Simple, easy, delicious, good for you. Beautiful. All right, goodbye, everybody. I'll see you next time. Let me know how your guacamole turns out. Bye, friends.